You won't believe this, but the love of my life, Miss Leah Grossman, who was my tap dancing teacher, is still alive. She's in her 90s, and she's in better shape than I am. And we've reconnected. It's been absolutely wonderful. And I think that was all part of it. I think that because I was doing something creative and unusual, because she said, when I was talking to you, she said, oh, you had something that none of the other kids had. I knew that I had to use you in the recitals. And I always had a special number in the recitals. You know, the first year, I was the farmer in the Dell with Joan Ciotti, and we had a little specialty number. And then the next year, I was a pirate. And then the next year, I was King Neptune. You know, besides doing, you know, my routines that I had learned with my dancing partners. And then I ended up with dancing with one girl named Carol Morrissey. And we were known as Tommy and Carol, the Mickey and Judy of Meriden. But all of that business. And then I got to art school. Of course, I had always been, you know, acting on the stage when I could. And we had I was in one play from the Meriden Community Theater. I played a young German Nazi from a very interesting play called Tomorrow the World. So when I got to Pratt, of course, I was going to enter, you know, join the Play Shop, which was a theater, extracurricular theater group. And so the first illustration class I had my sophomore year, Richard Lindner, the instructor, said to our class, I want you all to join Play Shop. Because being an illustrator is closely connected to theater. They're very connected because you start off with the play or the story. Then you have to cast the play. So you have to come up of all the characters in the story. So, you know, I know now there's my Strega Nona books have a little repertory company. So I know what Stregonona looks like, I know what Big Anthony looks like, I know what Bombalona looks like, the mayor, his wife, etc. Okay. Then I have to put them in costume. I have to design the costumes. Now, whether it's contemporary or make-believe Renaissance Italy or whatever, I have to put them in costume. Then I have to design the scenery, the setting. And then often in many of my books, I actually use a proscenium, you know, like a theater, because I've always wanted to, I've always wanted to do one of those. They were very popular in the Victorian era, you know, they had little theaters, little cutout theaters, and I've always wanted to do one. But, you know, that's, nobody wants to, you know, no one will buy it. But I don't know. That may not be true. Maybe I'll do that someday. But I really see a very strong connection. And then, of course, film is the same thing. It's the literary and the visual arts all rolled up together.